He would move mountains to assist anybody that needed help that he knew. He was a very sincere and loyal friend.
He was a warrior for justice. He didn't take no for an answer if he thought it was the right cause. When he spoke out, it was to make sure that everyone in the room was keeping it fair and honest.
What I remember most about Leon were his eyes. They were penetrating, deep, but kind. And his generosity just came out through his eyes. He was wonderful that way.
His pleasure was in spoiling other people. Just thinking about him and picturing his face in my mind's eye makes me smile.
I think Leon's generosity really came from the fact that, you know, he knew he came to this country as an immigrant. He remembered what it was like to be in that position. And Leon's ma, you know, she was big on giving back, saying, do what's right.
We have a lot in common through the Jewish faith. You know, his parents were quite Orthodox. So we had a bond there, if you will, through our histories. When you come from a background where you survived the war or the Holocaust or a significant event where everything is taken away from you and you have to start your life over, I think everything is appreciated. You appreciate what people do for you and what you can do for other people. And you want to make sure that the next generation understands what you went through and don't take what they have for granted. You know, he was special in that way. It wasn't about him, it was about the community around him, it was about other people.
He was a person who felt strongly about his beliefs. When he was a young fellow in Winnipeg and seeing people who were marginalized, not having a break or nobody there to champion their cause, you know, he stepped up to the plate, but just to do the right thing.
Our foundation is very humbled and honored to be receiving a gift that has this kind of transformational capability. $18.4 million, which is one of the largest gifts our foundation has ever received.
18 in the Jewish faith is a very meaningful number. It translates to the two letters Yud and Chet, which add up to 18. And when you reverse those letters, it spells Chai, which means life.
So if you give something with the number 18, actually you give the gift of life.
Leon's gift is going to make possible the creation of a brand new hybrid OR, or an interventional operating room, the creation of a new sleep clinic out at our UBC site, the new cardiology diagnostic center, and the Men's Health Initiative of British Columbia. Each of those four things is going to leap forward an area of healthcare that's going to benefit all British Columbians. When you take those four things in combination, the remarkable transformative power of this gift is truly breathtaking. It seems really appropriate. We are transforming what is now known as the Centennial Pavilion and renaming it the Leon Judah Blackmore Pavilion. We're very proud to take that important step. And we like to think that Leon is very proud too.
I think if Leon were here to see what his money was doing for our community, his eyes would light up. They would look at you and he would say, it's wonderful.
The way he approached life, the way he dealt with the world at large, it was never about himself. His entire focus was on how do I use that fortune to give back to society.
Leon leaves a message behind. Step outside of your comfort zone and do something to give back.
If Leon was still here and we were walking through the halls of UBC Hospital or VGH, Leon would look and say, wow, there are amazing people here who are doing incredible work that is having an immediate and profound impact on people's lives. How much more of a legacy can a person ask for?